Next up, we have creator, executive producer, writer, actor, Robin Thede of A Black Lady Sketch Show. But before we bring her on, I'm gonna show you this clip from the show.
This blood diamond on your finger is just a symbol of your ideological entrapment. Ring, ring, slavery's calling.
You promised you wouldn't do this. And that doesn't make any sense.
No, what doesn't make sense is y'all jumping the broom.
Haley, now is not the time.
Well, how many Caucasian seconds must pass before it's time for me to speak the truth? Open your ears to blow your mind, original people. Jumping the broom was not something our continental ancestors did, no. There weren't even brooms in Africa because there was no dirt. See, the Europeans just put sticks in our hands even though they had been using vacuum cleaners since the Middle Ages. Think about it. Dyson breaks down to die, son. They want us to kill our children.
Well, Robin, thank you for joining us, and thank you for A Black Lady Sketch Show. Yes!
You're welcome.
But, you know, what was the spark or the initial kind of catalyst to bring A Black Lady Sketch Show to all of the world?
To all of the world, honey. We're airing in multiple countries, okay? I always wanted to do this. My dream since I was a little kid was to be on SNL and to just play amazing characters. And then I had the opportunity to create my own sketch show. So this is actually like the sixth or seventh sketch show that I've acted on or written on, but it's the first one I got to create. So I'm so excited that the world has been able to see season one. And it's a crazy show because we took all these Black women, put them in this world where anything magical can kind of happen. And we get to play hundreds of amazing characters who you've never seen on any sort of sketch show before and who get to just play with the boundaries of what Black women can do in comedy. So it's just my dream.
The show, I mean, I've been it from the very beginning, of course, as you know.
Yes.
And I've been on board. The show manages to balance, you know, hot button topics affecting specific to Black women and, you know, women of color and just people in the margins. But how do you balance that with thoughtful execution, but also a good and, you know, hilarious helping of comedy throughout? It's just very much balanced. What are the challenges in that? And like, how do you navigate these hot button topics?
Yeah, look, I think being a Black woman is political and controversial in so many ways, just existing, right? So I think, you know, these are things that we think about a lot. We think about stan culture. We think about pop culture issues like cancel culture and Me Too and stuff like that. But when I was making the show, my inherently political statement was just to have four Black women in the cast of a sketch show and present it to the world in that way. So I don't think we wanted to go overly political or controversial. But in talking about things that we go through, I think you inherently hit some of those hot button topics like you were talking about. But first and foremost for us, it's about the jokes and it's about the comedy. We want to make sure that people are laughing, want to make sure that people get absorbed in these characters and these stories that we work so hard to bring to life. I think for us too, it's a narrative sketch show, right? So it's not just one joke over and over. Minutes, we can take you on a journey. We have full beginning, middles, and ends to the stories and the plots and characters come back. And it's really like watching all of these short films.
Yeah. It's funny you should mention that because, of course, like, normally sketch shows are just one and done, right? It goes up. But like, you have these recurring segments that, even like from the very first episode, the very end, which is very impressive, and just kind of weaving this narrative throughout.
Yeah, it is. And we wanted to take people on a journey. We wanted to take people on the journey of the individual sketches, but then also with our interstitial storyline, which is super relevant right now, where we are living at the end of the world, trapped in a house together, and eating all of our snacks. You know, we didn't know how prescient that was going to be, but, you know, I think I thought when we were initially writing season one that, you know, with Trump in the White House, anything was possible, right? So we pushed the boundaries of what reality could be for these women living in this world. And now it's just so much more relevant than we ever thought it would be. But it's fun to explore those themes. And I think a lot of the things that we thought about in the interstitial storyline that ties all these sketches together is happening now. So I think in that way, it really mirrors the human condition. think the funniest things are the things you can relate to the most, yeah. right? And so I think that's the core of what we try to do, is we try to make these sketches super relatable and super understandable for people in their everyday lives. Like, right, everybody doesn't have an yeah. HBO show, but everybody has issues with their coworkers, or everybody thinks that when they don't wear makeup, they look like they're dead, or, you know.
I mean, do you have, is there, I mean, it's acting like, asking like, do you have a favorite kid, but is there a certain sketch that specifically spoke to you?
Oh, God. All of them. I mean, I think there are so many sketches that we got to have fun with that I think about over and over and that resonate with other people. I think Courtroom Kiki is a sketch that all the women I know can relate to. Sketch about Black women walking into a courtroom, the lawyers, the judge, the plaintiffs, the bailiff, the stenographer, and they all see that they're all Black women, and they're like, oh my God, I've never seen this before. So they start thinking about it. But, you know, so that's like one of those, just like, you don't even have to think about it kind of sketches. And then we have sketches. I play this character, Dr. Hadassah Olayinka Youngman, pre-PhD, who is
pre-PhD.
Spoiler alert, she will never get
it. Are we all pre-PhD in a way?
Yes, everyone is pre-PhD. You get the joke. So yeah, it's like playing her is so great because she wraps up all these different conspiracy theorists and sort of people who I find absolutely fascinating and hilarious. So, you know, playing like outlandish characters like that, but grounding them in a place where people are like, I know that person, I think is the sweet spot for us.
Well, you know, also, you guys got picked up for a second season, right? Yay, yay, second season, hey! but you know, right now, especially, you know, second season, what can we expect from that? And, you know, the show already speaks to representation, like you said, you know, being a show about Black women, for Black women, telling their narratives, you know, that in itself is, you know, in a way, you can't help it. It's political, right? But what can we expect in season two? How are we going to move that narrative forward? How is it going to continue to move the needle for representation for marginalized communities?
It is going to be bigger and better. Lots more guest stars, lots more craziness. You're going to see some of your favorite characters come back. We get to meet new characters in this universe and find out what they're doing and how they exist in their spaces. So I think, you know, the list of issues that folks deal with day to day is not short. So the material that we have on our sketch show is endless. You know, I think that people just want to continue to see themselves, whether they're Black, white, male, female, non-gender conforming, whatever, age, you know, it doesn't matter. We had everyone from Angela Bassett to Marseille Martin on the show and in between. You know, we had 50 guest stars in 6 episodes. We had a core cast of 4 women playing over 100 characters in just 6 episodes. I mean, it's crazy the amount we accomplished in season 1, and I know we're only going to up that bar in season 2.
So, I mean, like, you've had, like you said, like 50 guest stars for season.
It's
50
crazy.
More? Who is on your wish list now?
Oh, well, Beyonce and Blue Ivy have always been on my, you know this. So, you know, fingers crossed. But yeah, it's going to be amazing. Obviously, I can't say who's going to be on.
Why
but,
not? We're deadline. We're,
yeah. I think it's going to be, all I can say is everyone wants to come play. After season one, we were able to get all those people because they were so excited about the concept of the show and the people involved. Our executive producer, Issa Rae, my history in the business, our core cast, Quinta Brunson, Gabrielle Dennis, Ashley Nicole Black, and myself. I think everybody just wanted to be a part of this, you know? And in season 2, now that they've seen it, they're like, oh yeah, okay. So anybody who was like a little nervous before is like, really like, okay, they're gonna take care of it. It's gonna be funny, let's cool. go. So I think, you know, a lot of people, unexpected and non, have been calling me up to get wow. on it, so I'm excited.
Well, Robin, thank you so much. I was one of the people that called you to be on it as well. I was joking. But no, thank you and congratulations on such a great show, and thank you for joining us.